Hi guys, for those who are new here, my name is Miss Katrina, the Caribbean Queen. Yes sir, they know me as the Caribbean Queen because I love reggae music, I love dancehall music, and for me, the Caribbean Queen is defined by the passion that I have for reggae music, okay? And when I say reggae music, that is inclusive of lovers rock, roots, mizizi, and of course, dancehall music, not forgetting anything that describes reggae music, okay? And I'm super excited to take you through this journey because previously I traveled to Germany and a lot of people hawako wanaelewa mbona nilikuwa nimeenda Germany. I had gone for a specific event, which was one event, and that was Summer Jam. And if you're new here, you haven't subscribed, please make sure you do so. Comment, share, and like. Now, let me introduce you to Summer Jam. For those who don't understand what is Summer Jam. Summer Jam is one of the biggest reggae events in Europe and let's say also the world. Yo, basically Summer Jam niya ku celebrate the Jamaican culture, the reggae culture, but more specifically the dancehall culture, because there are different reggae events maju, especially in Europe times summer. So how did I even think of going to Summer Jam? How did I even come with the idea of going to Summer Jam? I don't know, sijui nitaidescribe aje kwa sababu even if it's something I envisioned kufanya ama kuenda, it wasn't this year. So this year was very abrupt for me kuenda Summer Jam. Now let me start from the beginning. How did it start? Where did the idea come from? Now I remember a friend of mine who is in Germany, anaitwa Mandecho. Nakumbuka earlier on this year tulikuwa tunaongea and planning, on whether I'll go for Summer Jam or not. Of course, previously nimekutana na what is summer, ama like nimekutana na wasa wakisema, we wanna go to Summer Jam, we wanna go to Reggae Guild, we wanna go to, Rotterdam. Those are some of the events that it was gonna happen in Europe. But for me, specifically, Summer Jam was in my mind. So, ini ile time ndo nilikuwa nimetoka NTV. Nilikuwa nimemalizana na mambo ya TV, nikasema I need to take a break. But also I felt like it came at the right time. So, hiyo time nilitoka randomly tu nikasema, siwezi toka tenje na niko hapa Kenya, I must find something. But at the same time, the reason as to why I opted to do Summer Jam is for me to go and learn, number one. Number two, network. Number three, see what is different from what is done outside compared to what, is being done in Kenya in terms of reggae music, in terms of events, in terms of hosting, in terms of content creation when it comes to reggae. Now, katiwa nikasema, utamfungia kwa mfuko. Sikuwa nimeplan, trust me, this is something that I had not planned. Katiwa, nikapigia bishti yangu, nikamambia, I think I might come to Germany for Summer Jam. Wako like, uko serious? Wako like, yes. I decided to just go to the portal near Germany, nione, what are the rules and regulations of applying for a visa? Kumbuka sikuwa nimeenda Europe. I had previously planned to go in Norway, but it never happened. Nini nyimwa visa. Fast forward, I got the visa. I got everything that I was supposed to do, to get. Nikamua sasa wacha tuanze safari. Katiwa, ndio huyo, mimi, shuuu. Sina kazi. Nimebaki na job ya radio peke yake. So I had to request for a leave. Now, when I was going to Germany, ama immediately nilifika Germany, a lot of people thought, because I never told anyone, not even my closest friends, they had a rough idea of me going. But in terms of like me, kuisema and all that, it's something I did not. So what are you going to do when I'm already there? So I meet with my friend. Kumbuka, I bought my own ticket. Nataka ku make this clear. I had no sponsor. And for the third time, I had no sponsor. Who sponsored my trip? niliingia kwa mfuko yangu, nikasema, now for me to get outside my comfort zone, we have also to take you know, some risks. So nikamwa, I'll pay for my trip, yoni return ticket. Kubai ticket ya Summer Jam, if you don't buy it at an early you know, stage, uta itakuwa a bit expensive. So for me nili buy 17,000, ilikuwa 17,000 kabla ifike 20,000, and that for 3 days. Summer Jam happens for 3 days, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, and I think it's one of the first events za you know, summer zenye huwa zina happen, I mean huwa ina happen kabla the rest zifuatilie. So inakuanga yani ni kitu iko na mpangilio huko. So nimefika, nimebook hoteli, nimeanza sherehe zangu polepole, nimekutana na mabishi zangu.
Ah, the beauty over here is unseen, is unmatched. Oh Lord.
You know, I had a couple of people to call. I didn't know what was the protocol. Watu walikuwa nalala wapi? So nilikuwa naambiwa just be prepared because we are going to camp for 3 good days. Niko like my. Abudu sijai camp. I know nothing about camping. We get to the place, location, ilikuwa inaitwa Colon. It's a big city. It's quite a big city by the way in Germany. Tuka camp the first Thursday, and then on Friday the event in Anza.
Hapa ni Tarena Shida.
So for me, intention yangu ilikuwa iyo Friday itakuwa ni kunetwork. Hata staki kujua ni nani ana perform, staki kujua nani ni host. I just needed to network. I just needed to know who's the planner, nani mwenye event, nani ufanya hivi. But one thing that stood out for me was nikiingia hiyo event ama hiyo time on Friday when event ilikuwa inaanza, which ilikuwa afternoon, nakumbuka kulikuwa na advertising ya other events zenye zilikuwa zinakuja after Summer Jam, and that was like Reggae Jam, and I was like, ay, in Kenya we don't see this, we rarely see this, and this is something that we need to wake up and we need to love ourselves more when it comes to supporting our own. If you know my event is happening on a Friday, please don't go find another person mwenye unajua nafanya event kama yangu mugonganishe. No, it's not healthy, but that's not even the point. So on Friday we get there, and before we even go to the main stage, because kulikuwa na like 3 different stages, I think 2, kulikuwa na green stage na kulikuwa na red stage. Kulikuwa na Wakenya, of course kulikuwa na different people from different you know, spaces of the world. Nakumbuka kulikuwa na Wakenya wengi mali tulikuwa tuna doze, na mmoja akanishow akaniambia, by the way, unaona huyu msemo mwenye amelala hapa next, huyu ndo msemo mwenye Reggae Jam. Nilikuwa like, what? I was so excited. First of all, mi hata sikuwa na like siku shika hiyo tamia Reggae Jam, mi nilisikia tu Summer Jam because of Summer Jam ndio ilikuwa kwa mind yangu. So and for me that was exciting because I felt like God alikuwa na align vitu zangu na plans zangu. So immediately I didn't even waste a time or a dime. Went and approached him and I was like, hi, my name is Miss Katia the Caribbean Queen and I come from Kenya, blah 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 blah, and this is what I do. And I niskiza tu ni Germany. Okay, so what would you want me to do for you? But before even that, you know, kumbuka kulikuwa na a lot of people wenye wamsurround. So he's basically one person mwenye ako very frequent, I mean very free with people. And so for me nilikuwa like, I would love to pitch myself, I would love to tell you what I can do. So that even in the near future, even if it doesn't happen today or in the next few weeks or whatsoever, it's something that and it's something that yenye naweza nataka kufanya even in the future. Akaniambia, okay, so that's how I met the owner mwenye Reggae Jam. Now kumbuka tuko Summer Jam. Well, after nilipata contact za mwenye Reggae Jam, nilikuwa like, now I can relax. This is barely the first day and I'm super excited and I just don't know what is happening to me. So nakumbuka kulikuwa na a lot of artists wenye walikuwa na perform. When we went to the green stage, ama was it the red stage, either of them, nakumbuka Lilaike was the first artist that I saw. Oh my God.
Oh,
Lilaike. Do you guys know Lilaike? Oh my god. I mean, Anasa Kenya said true love above all things. Oh, it's gonna be alright. Because Kenya full of vibes. You don't know, this is Lilaike. Lilaike is one of the baddest reggae females, reggae artists when it comes to reggae music in Jamaica. She's so fresh. And discovery yangu kwa Lilaike, I came to find out, or rather I came to know her when Proto J was doing some projects with Chronix. Then Lilaike ndio huyo akatokea. And for me it was really exciting because I was seeing artists that nilikuwa na wish ku interview when I was here, ama like when I was back home. These are artists wenye sikuwa tana neza access because some of them are very, very difficult to find. Now, apart from even that, I mean Lilaike though was conscience ali bring fire. Ay. Y'all know Conscience, yes, a dancehall artist from Jamaica. And a lot of people were on a prayer sana kuna Conscience akiperform because, again, you know, there's this specific dancer, wa Conscience. She brought the house down. Let me tell you, she brought the house down. So apart from even Lilaike, seeing the performance of Lilaike, Conscience, Chris Martin, for me was the first time seeing Chris Martin perform outside Kenya. I've had a conversation with Chris Martin, not as much. And seeing his performance in Kenya was quite different from what I saw in Europe. And it ilinifanya nikaji question a lot. What is it that we are not giving to these artists, or what are these artists not giving us when it comes to them performing back home? And you could see even how they were loving the stages and everything else. Like, events in Europe are so different compared to home. And you would see the energy, you'd see the crowd, and you'd like, ute, unasi tunapafomi wanga tunaangalia msani hivi. Msani, huko ni kama hata wasa. Mafans ni kama melipo, yani kuchangamuka kuona msani. And it was very exciting, but at the same time, I was questioning myself a lot. A lot of artists wenye nilikuwa naona huko, waki perform, are the same artist wenye nimeona wakiperform hapa, but there's a very big difference. It's either the way we handle them, it's either, you know, the money that we give them, or I just don't know, it's either the stages. It doesn't make sense to me, but I would love, if you ask me, I would love to see, you know, the kind of energy that they were using, they were showing in Europe ikileto back home. Now, there was Stylo G. That was the first time for me to see Stylo G. Excuse you. Like, guys, hello, Stylo G. This is one of the dopest dancehall artists. Julian Marley. Who ni mtoto wa Bob Marley? Yeah. For me, that was like being able to see Bob Marley performing, but you know, rest in peace. That's a legendary. This is a kid to a legendary. Huu ni mtu wa legendary. Na hata tuwezi bishana naye. And even kwa toi watu wa Bob Marley. He's one of the most successful. One of the most because kuna Damian Marley, kuna wase wengi sana, ama kuna watu wengi sana. There's also Sean Paul. Bro, do I need to talk about Sean Paul? Talk about Sean Paul. No. And for me, it was really, really exciting because Sean Paul is one of those artists from Jamaica mwenye amebeba flag yao na amerepresent culture yao to the fullest. Sean Paul, remember, amemanage kukulaborate na wase kama Beyonce. Amekulaborate na wase wengi kwa hii dunia. Wase wa bigi sana, kina Busta Rhymes.
Sean Paul.
Yo, yo.
I bust the rhymes listen up.
Wow,
pass me the blowtorch when me light this big head, nigga.
No, no.
Bring that cum road boy.
I'm done. Just give me the light and pass the job.
Sean Paul is Sean Paul. And for me, it was an exciting moment. It was, like it was just... Design nakumbuka nilikuwa naambia beshte yangu, if I'm not able to record this, kindly record it with your phone. Kwa sababu for me, I wanted to take everything. I wanted everything to sink in. I wanted to live that moment of being able to see, you know, these artists in big stages. Wase wenye nilikuwa na dream ku meet. But Sean Paul, I've been able to, you know, have an interview with him previously when I was still on TV. And for me, still that was a moment. But getting to see him on stage and him performing with different artists and how he relates, you know, his presence and how people felt when he got to the stage. Hii ilikuwa kitu ingine moment moja amazing sana. So for me, being able to see Sean Paul, 100%. Now, Steph London, nakumbuka Steph London, it depends on how you pronounce the name. Kuna wenye wanasema Steph London, Stefflon London. London was one of the females actually that I was able to see perform, and nakumbuka hiyo time nilikuwa nimechelewa because I was juggling different stages. Julian Marley was performing on a different stage and I wanted to make sure that nime record your moment na nime capture, even if I won't be able to interview them, because remember I was new to Summer Jam, I didn't know anyone, so ilikuwa process for me to get these people, for me to find this artist, for me to even know who is doing who is doing what and everything. Now remember, according to how nili experience Summer Jam, uko stages ziko different na pia like tickets ziko different. Kuna ticket itakwambia uko na access ya location A to B. Kuna ticket inasema location yako ni C to D. Kuna ticket yenye inasema wewe location yako ni A. But kuna ticket yenye ni all access na hiyo iko na A, B, C, D, E, F, yani hiyo ni all access kabisa. So you can literally access anywhere. But the ticket that I had, which I bought when I was still here, ilikuwa ticket tu ya normal, the common person, like you'll go see the artist performing and all that. But nakumbuka, there's a time when Spice was performing, cause Spice is a different story, because for me I was really, 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 really waiting to see Spice perform. And I wanted to have an interview with Spice, I wanted to have a one-on-one conversation with Spice. Out of all the artists when walikuwa Summer Jam, because for me I realized that Summer Jam is quite different from Reggae Jam, yenye nilienda. Of which Summer Jam is more like the dancehall music, the energy. Because I artist wa reggae mwenye niliona ni Julian Marley, kulikuwa na Third World, I think pia kulikuwa na very few, let's just say few reggae artists. Three quarter ilikuwa dancehall artist. So for me I felt like Summer Jam ina represent the culture ya dancehall music, the energetic culture, the youngins, because Europe loves dancehall music compared to reggae music. Kenya or Africa, we adore reggae music. In Europe, it's dancehall music. Kwa sababu there will be a time you'd see a legendary performing, a reggae artist, Mtuka Julian Marley, but you'd find a lot of people wako kwa dancehall tent. It's because for them, they're used to dancehall music. They are relating more with dancehall music. And there's nothing wrong with that because I've realized it now. Kenyan culture, reggae music, the way we celebrate their culture in our country is we love reggae music, we love roots, not compared to how we love dancehall music. So being able to see Spice perform on stage, na nakumbuka alikuwa na perform na Stylo G, it was so amazing. Nakumbuka Sean Paul, Shaggy, they came because of the collaboration that nyamefanya pamoja, one and go down, and it was amazing because people were screaming, and every artist had a different presence when it came to them performing. Spice, her energy is unmatched, period. Even something that we see, whatever you guys see Spice posting, that is how she performs. Introduce myself again.
Yes.
My name is Miss Katiwa.
Okay.
I come from Kenya. Nice meeting you. They call me the Caribbean Queen in Kenya.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Well, and nice I was at your show at Summer Jam.
Mm-hmm.
And when I posted your picture, people went crazy because people love you so much.
Oh, that's amazing.